Hi guys, as usual it's me, just a voiceover, and this is Review Machines, and the newest tracked all-terrain vehicle, Pellets, 85 HP. It's time to begin, let's go! Guys, take seats in our ATV, cause today it's going to be an interesting adventure. Now we are moving across the huge swamp, and we'll overcome numerous tough obstacles to get our final destination. And today the destination is a great lake, a real freshwater sea. I have never seen it before, cause the only way to get there is this swampy road, where only serious ATV can move. And today we have such an ATV. You might have noticed that I'm driving the newest ATV Pellets, that has one of the most powerful engines in this class of vehicles. By the way, some time ago, we already made a video about Pellets ATV. But this time we have absolutely another model, and it's really worth of our attention. So let's stop and take a little rest, and I'll tell you a few words about this newest ATV. Well, this ATV is called Pellets Rover, and it's entirely made of a qualitative steel. This vehicle has a wide range of use. It's all-season ATV, it's both good on dirt and snow, and it can be used for work and recreation. The main idea of this machine is to replace both a quad and a snowmobile, and sometimes even a boat. By the way, the engineers knowingly chose steel as a main material for the body and the frame. As a result, the vehicle is very robust. It isn't afraid of bumps and hummocks. We'll speak about it a bit later, and now it's time to continue our trip. Let's move on. Our way is an old forest road to the abandoned pit cut mines. The road is dry enough, and our ATV shows here its power and acceleration. The vehicle is equipped with the engine 1-liter capacity and 85 horsepower. Theoretically, on a decent road, the maximum speed is about 70 km per hour, but we didn't have conditions to check if it is true. But the acceleration is really very impressive. The ATV weighs 750 kilos, but it moves so swiftly, like a much lighter machine. It's able to get 50 km per hour just in 5 seconds. And of course, a significant advantage of any skid steering machine – it's a great maneuverability. It's able to turn around literally on the spot. That's so useful on such narrow roads. The further we went, the worse the road was. Sometimes it was completely overgrown with young trees and bushes, and we had to cut our way through the thicket. Our rider forgot his helmet, and it was a mistake taking into account the conditions of this route. But thanks to the anti-roll cage, he wasn't hurt by any tree. Besides, good steel and the armoring paint also do a lot of good in such conditions, so you may be not afraid of any scratches. Now let our rider have a little rest, and meantime, let's look at some specs. Firstly, look what we have under the hood. Here it is, 1-liter capacity engine, 85 horsepower. It's V-type 2-cylinder engine with water cooling system. There is a Canadian CVT transmission. Smooth riding is provided by an effective suspension system. Each roller has its own spring and shock. The tracks are 4.5 meters length and 380 millimeters width. The working life of the tracks is about 3500 kilometers. There is a skid steering, a standard solution for a tracked ATV, a handlebar with a throttle and brakes, like on a motorcycle, and there is a display on it. That's the whole dashboard. There are 4 seats with adjustable armchairs, The total carrying capacity is 800 kilos. I like the body design, quite effective, what do you think? And it's very practical on off-roading. For example, these headlights look awesome, and they are perfectly protected by the body elements. Meantime, we are moving on. And suddenly, our route in the forest led us to the huge trash place, covered with numerous logs. Certainly, it's a gloomy view, isn't it? But on the other hand, it's a good test for our ATV. Let's see how it can handle it. It's worth saying that it's almost impossible to move here on a viewed vehicle, like a quad, for example. There are plenty of holes between the logs, and it's very easy to get stuck in a hole with the wheel. But the tracks have a chance to overcome this place. Moreover, the tracks are strengthened with the steel, so they are very robust, and it's a very hard task to tear them. And the steel bodies also can resist many bumps against the logs, as opposed to a plastic. But it's passed the test. Let's move on. The nearer we come to the lake, the more swampy the ground becomes. In fact, all this area is the huge ancient swamp. When ATV is passing next to us, we can feel the ground trembling, and that is rather scary thing, I should say. Any small puddle here may become a bog hole. That is why it's very tough to move here by a wheeled vehicle. But our tracked ATV is cut out for such conditions. Long tracks, decent ground clearance, and powerful engine provide excellent performance on a swampy ground. But when you are moving on such terrain, the fuel consumption is quite serious. It's about 12 liters per hour. For example, on a good road it's 5 liters. Meantime, we got to the abandoned turf mines. Now all of them are full of water, as you can see. To proceed our way to the Great Lake, we had to cross this water obstacle. By the way, I may have missed one important feature about this vehicle. It's amphibious. Its body is like a steel boat, so it can easily float. To move on water with a decent speed, it's recommended to install a water screw. But we didn't have it, so the only way to move here was by rotating the tracks. But this way is rather slow, I should say. Suddenly, the forest and swamp was left behind. We felt a fresh wind touch our skin and heard gulls' cries. That's it, we've got our destination. Yes, the Great Lake really impresses. It's a real freshwater sea. And we are so grateful to our ATV, that it helped us to get this awesome place. Let us have a few moments to enjoy the view. And now it's high time to speak about the prices. This model costs about $12,000. I don't know if it's much or not, but take into account that the money is almost the same as a regular quad's price. So guys, please leave comments with your opinions. What do you think is better, a regular quad or this ATV? Thanks for having this little trip with us. Please subscribe the channel if you like this video. Stay with us, it will be many more interesting materials here. Goodbye!